everyone. My name is Arisa. I am a fourth-year undergraduate geology student at the Jackson School of Geosciences at the University of Texas at Austin. I am graduating this May, and I'll be moving into the energy industry and hopefully be pursuing a graduate study in marine geology afterwards. Geologic hazards affect people's life directly, whether it be an earthquake, a tsunami, or a landslide. Many geoscientists are interested in how these hazards can shape the Earth, as well as possible hazard predictions. In 2017, Hurricane Harvey hit the Texas coast as a Category 4 hurricane. Hurricane Harvey is known for its catastrophic flood, but it also impacted so much of the shoreline's shape through sediments or sand transport. My research project looks at how the flow of water due to the hurricane generate deeply scarred channels on the beach. If we know where the big changes in the beach could be and how they form, we can help guide projects such as beach nourishment, making our coastlines and people's lives more resilient to hurricanes over time. Here are aerial photographs of San Jose Island, which is the barrier island just north of Mustang Island in Texas. The left side is before Harvey. The beach was pristine. The right side is after Harvey. You can see that these many long channels lying perpendicularly to the shoreline just popped right up. The offshore wind piled the water inside the bay up, allowing it to flow into the ocean, carving out all of these erosional features. We went down to look at them closely, and I took measurements in the channels and found that the water has transported so much sand out the beach that it would take quite a while for the beach to recover. The modeling results show that we can tell locations that are most susceptible to erosion and where the channels would be forming in 2017 just based on the pre-storm topography data alone, which is really exciting. I grew up in Bangkok, Thailand, and my family wanted me to study medicine, but I did not want to. I've always been interested in science, and so in my last year of high school, I went to geoscience camps to check them out. And we identified rocks, used compass, and learned how to think like geoscientists. At one camp, our team of four walked a part of a mountain and came up with a geologic map. And that was my first geologic map. I was so fascinated by the sense of discovery and the teamwork aspect of the discipline, and I decided to pursue geology in college. In Thailand, geology is not a famous field. Most of my friends end up pursuing medicine or engineering. It was not all easy to break away from the cultural norms, but I'm really glad that I did it. If something speaks to you and you have done your research, you should be your number one cheerleader to pursue what you think is best. Last December, I had an opportunity to present my project at the American Geophysical Union Fall Meeting in Washington, D.C., which is the largest annual earth sciences gathering in the world. Throughout the week, I got to talk to many geoscientists and got me even more excited on the project. This research project also won the Best Undergraduate Poster Award for the Jackson School of Geosciences Symposium. Moving forward, I'll be giving an oral presentation on the project in Vienna, Austria, during the European Geosciences Union General Assembly. College is about putting what you believe into action. It's not going to be all easy, but you gain such appreciation from overcoming each obstacle. And I wish everyone good luck.